Alright, so it's Tuesday, September 23rd, and I probably left my house 10 minutes ago, and I haven't gotten that far at all. As soon as I got on the highway, there was traffic. I don't know what's going on. I leave around this time every day. I have Waze on my phone, like, telling me, like, updates if there's an accident or something. We're literally going, and it says on the app, 16 miles per hour on the highway. So, I don't know. I'm hoping I get there on time. We also have a sub today because my teacher has a doctor's appointment or something. So, I'm kind of hoping the sub maybe will let me come in, like, a couple minutes late if I'm late. Hopefully, once I get up to the exit, there's no traffic there, but we'll see. And then Makeup Forever is coming today. And although I don't have any of their products, I'm so excited because it is like a big makeup company. But they usually tell you to look nice because this could be a job opportunity. Salons come in, big companies like this. Yesterday we had European Wax, and that was really cool because I've heard of it, but I didn't really know what they do. And it's a facility just specialized for waxing. It was really cool to listen to, and I'm excited to see what Makeup Forever says today and if they have any job opportunities. I don't know if it'd be like a stand at a mall or if they have their own like place around here. I don't know, but I'm excited to see what they say and what opportunities I could have from them and if they like my makeup, because I wish I had something from Makeup Forever so I could be like, yeah, I'm wearing your foundation. But I thought that maybe might be weird. I don't know, because Mary Kay, they're always like, you have to be at least wearing one thing of Mary Kay so you can tell people. I'm kind of over that. Car accident. Three car accidents reported ahead. Well, this should be fun. I'm going to eat my Special K. These have been like my ish. This is my Special K pastry crisps, and I get the chocolatey delight one. There's also like a berry one. Strawberry and I feel like blueberry. And then there's a cookies and cream one, but it's like, this is like the white cracker and then the chocolate, and that's like the chocolate cracker and the chocolate. It's just too chocolatey for me, so I don't eat that one. But I've been eating these every morning just to get a little something in my stomach, because if I eat as soon as I wake up in the morning, I get sick. I mentioned that in like another vlog. Like, my stomach will hurt for the whole day and I'll be thrown off. So I don't usually eat until later. Let's see what happened. There's one car there. Oh! The whole front of that car is smashed up. And look, now there's no traffic! Woo! It sounds like I'm speeding away, but I'm only going 40 miles per hour on the highway. I love how every morning I'm on the highway that I drive to school on, I can see the tip of the Empire State Building. And I just think that from Alex's dorm room, he can see the city too and the Empire State Building and stuff. So every morning when I'm driving to school, I think of him and I'm like, oh, he could be looking at that too right now. But he's probably still asleep. I can't believe that one accident like that caused that much traffic. Like, once you get around it, there's literally, it looks like there's no one on the highway right now. I literally just turned the camera back on because there is another accident. And I'm in traffic again. Ah! You need a girl, gotta blow your mind.
Like a Harley, then pull off in this Ferrari. From G to the A to the N to G to the R&B.
Alright, so I am on my way home from school. I literally just got out, and the one highway is completely full of traffic. So it looks like I'm gonna have to go the long way past the deli again. I just wish one day, like, it wasn't full of traffic so I could go home so much quicker, but even though this is the long way, I guess it is quicker to go home. Makeup Forever came, and it was really cool, like, having someone from a big company like that be there. But the teacher surprised us and set up classes that we could go to. Usually they're only like $25, $50 classes. We're going to the classes for free. We got to sign up for the backstage pass, like coupon. So basically, if you're a makeup artist, you have your license, or you're a student. Students get 20% off, so you're gonna send me that backstage pass. I get 20% off all Makeup Forever products, and I think I can use that Sephora too, so that'll definitely come in handy, like, all the time. I have never personally tried Makeup Forever, but everyone talks about it, and I'm excited to go to one of these classes, learn how to do a bunch of stuff. They were going to talk about contouring, they were going to talk about day to night looks, and I think a business, like, professional look. So yeah, I'm going to learn all that and use their products. And they said, yeah, it is a free class, and yeah, you're going to use our products, but you don't get to keep them. But we're allowed to buy them afterwards, which I'm totally going to do. So yeah, I'm really excited for that, to get my, you know, my backstage pass, like, in the mail, stuff like that. And I'm excited to see if I hear from them. Basically, Sephora and Makeup Forever are, like, sister stores, so the job opportunity would be at Sephora. But we'll see if I hear from anyone. It's just interesting because I only work at the place I normally work at on weekends now. But it would be nice to do something in my field that I could go to after school. Like, during the week, at nights preferably. You know, make a little extra money, and I wouldn't mind doing something I want to do. Now, going from beauty school to go work at a kid's party place, that's a totally different story. Hi, Dante's. There's the deli. So today, I guess when I was vlogging this morning in the traffic and I was eating my Chocolatey Delight Special K bars, I must have put it down in between my lap because I have a remote for my radio. And I put it in between my lap so I don't have to, like, you know, search around for it and stuff like that. And I think I put the Special K bar in between my legs because I look and there's chocolate, like, down there. And I was like, oh my God. Oh, wait. No, I didn't try it. But if I did, I went like this. I'm like, yeah, that's chocolate. So, I got chocolate down there, and then, if you see here, I don't know if you can see, ow, my shirt right here, there's all blood, because I must have had some sort of bump or something, and I, like, went to go pick it or scratch it, and it started bleeding, and I thought it was my red lipstick on my finger, but it was blood. And it bled through my shirt. Thank God it didn't bleed through my lab coat because, oh my God, that would have sucked. But yeah, it bled through my shirt. And then thank God the girl next to me had a Band-Aid because it was still bleeding when I lifted up my shirt. And I remember I checked at lunch and then it was like that I scratched it. And I was like, oh, lipstick on my finger? Yeah. No, but it was like an hour or two later. And it was still, like, open and bloody. I was like, ugh. But I'm gonna have to wash the shirt. There's, like, literally blood spots. Oh, I don't know if you can see, like, all right here. And I have a Band-Aid. Like, look. Ugh. She literally. And there's these boys riding their scooters, not skateboards, scooters right here. And they, okay. There was this girl in a convertible music playing. She was blonde, pretty, whatever. Rips the head off a teddy bear and throws its head on the ground in front of my car as these boys on their scooters are going. And everyone was like, oh my God. I guess somebody went through a bad breakup. I did that once. Well, not really. So, before I was dating Alex, the only other serious relationship I had was about 6 months, and he gave me a teddy bear. And, like, the breakup wasn't bad at all. Like, we were only in eighth grade, and we literally were just like, maybe we shouldn't date anymore, because this is kind of, like, complicated and ridiculous. Like, it was a mutual, you know, like, this is dumb kind of thing. And I literally, he gave me all this stuff, and, like, he made me a pillow in his home ec class that my cat used and, like, ruined, like, peed on it, like, got hair all over it. It was ruined. All the pictures we ever took together, for some reason, I deleted, even though, like, there were only five. I, for some reason, deleted them. I don't know why. He gave me a teddy bear, and it was pink and adorable. I don't even know. I gave it to my dog, and my dog ripped the head off of it. It wasn't even on purpose. I was just like, oh, here, you want a toy? I don't cuddle with this anymore. Gave it to Ralph, and Ralph ripped his head off. Oh, good times. So, I'm here editing vlogs and a beauty video. Yes. Alexa wanted me to formally apologize for blaming her for taking my lunch.
Because I didn't.
Because it turns out that the guys who work at my uncle's deli just forgot to put my lunch in my bag. I was talking to two people at the same time, and they were going back and forth getting me what I wanted, and they both put it in two separate bags. So, yeah. They apologized to me on Friday when I went in and said hi to them. And I apologize to Alexa for blaming her.
I'm very offended.
Taking my orange soda and my salt and vinegar chips.
You sent me very angry text messages.
All right, we won't get it. We just ate dinner. My mom made chicken pot pie, so that was really good. And I'm probably just going to edit some videos and then watch Dancing with the Stars. All right, so it's 11:15 and I'm about to go to bed, but I couldn't end this vlog without making a comment on Dancing with the Stars. The person that got voted off should not have gotten voted off. The other guy, the race car driver, I forget his name, should have been voted off. Definitely think that they voted the wrong person off. I was just so surprised when Sadie Robertson got put in Jeopardy. I honestly think she did an amazing job. I don't know why she was getting penalized for her choreography. She didn't come up with the choreography, obviously. Whatever choreography was given to her, she obviously did a wonderful job. My last comment is, oh no, two more. One, when they dropped Julianne Hough on the floor, oh my God, like my heart stopped beating for a second. And then when they did the actual performance, he put her on his shoulder and spun her, but then stopped her because it looked like she was gonna fall again. So yeah, that was a disaster. And then the last thing is Maddie Ziegler, whatever, from Dance Moms. Like, my sister religiously watches Dance Moms, and Maddie is on there, and she is an amazing dancer. It's pretty good so far. I'm loving all the people on it. And I keep telling my friend Dan that he looks exactly like Jonathan, the guy from Mean Girls, and he didn't believe me until I sent him a picture of Sadie and Jonathan together, and I was like, you look so much like Jonathan, and I could probably look like Sadie, and we could recreate that photo. So I'm gonna go to bed, and I'm probably not going to vlog for the rest of the week, hopefully Friday, but we'll see. It is me and Alex's 4-year anniversary, so we're going to be going out and doing something, and I'm hopefully going to be staying there, so we'll see.